Thank you very much. Merci beaucoup. Excellences, messieurs les chefs d'État et du gouvernement, distingués invités, mesdames et messieurs, je voudrais remercier les organisateurs de la présente rencontre.
First of all, to thank the organizers of today's conference for inviting me to take part in the discussions on this very important issue of the emergency, climate emergency, COVID-19 emergency. My country, Niger, has always given the priority to policies to alleviate climate change. The chairmanship of President Hamadou, who was the first president of the Climate Commission for the Sahel region. He committed himself relentlessly to mobilize funding and mobilize all energies in our region by initiating a program to deploy the transitional framework for the Climate Commission here in Niamey. And therefore, I'm particularly honored to dedicate one of my first speeches as a newly elected President of the Republic of Niger to this topic. It is urgent that governments and states all over the world scale up initiatives, fundings, and partnerships to accelerate adaptation to climate change. The discussions we are having today are a perfect opportunity to build up a strategic consensus in order to achieve this objective. Ladies and gentlemen, I noted in the agenda of today's conference that our discussions will evolve around three need to be scaled up and speeded up, partnerships and funding. And I've also noted that to do so, a contribution on climate ambition should be made. In this respect, I would like to say that the COVID-19 crisis unfortunately cast a shadow on climate crisis, and in the meantime, the impacts of climate change is. We believe, however, that the international community should continue and even intensify the efforts in order to build up climate change and climate resilience in Africa, and also the recovery plans for COVID-19 crisis should focus on the impacts of climate change, and particularly the impact of climate change on the vulnerability of local populations, which are deprived of their revenues, and it hits our youth, particularly leading them or pushing them into the arms of organized crime or terrorists. This shows how urgent this compounded crisis is, the COVID-19 crisis and the climate change crisis. Therefore, we need to take up the challenge by dedicating bold efforts in order to improve our population's resilience. And over the past decades, we have increased our actions on the fight against hunger, hunger alleviation also in our country and our continent. All the more, this program is perfectly in line with the Africa Adaptation Acceleration Program, AAAP. My country attaches great importance to this program, especially in terms of the integrated cross-border programs and also the fight against pests in agriculture and farming, also a determined effort in Niger through adaptation programs to the benefits of our youth and women particularly. Ladies and gentlemen, it is absolutely indispensable that developed countries do keep their promises taken in the Paris Agreement by dedicating $100 billion annually to the benefits of developing countries and innovating initiatives on this continent. Similar initiatives at the P3A, the Climate Investment Plan for the Sahel region, in the Priority Program 2021, which mobilizes three contributions up to $3.41 billion, are being suspended and depend on this commitment. And I would like to pay tribute to the African Development for the decision it made to mobilize $12.6 billion over the period 2020-2025, an amount that will be dedicated to programs and projects in Africa. This will add up to the current budgets already and dedicated for the period 2020-2025, as announced during our roundtable that was held in February. Thank you very much for your kind attention.